tiny little hole out of your skin,
dude.
And then then they just slide the foot under, and so your skin goes.
Tell me about piercings. That looks like it hurt. Did it hurt?
Yeah, I've had it for so long, I don't exactly remember the pain. But piercings, they hurt, but they're so quick that it's
boom.
Over and boom. Yeah,
you got. You have to take special care of piercings?
Yes, with our aftercare product that we use, H2 Ocean, which is amazing. But after that, like once it's healed up and done properly by one of our piercers, it's gold. Nothing to worry about.
Really?
Yeah.
You still want to snag it on a towel? Other than that, you're.
Yeah. Other than that, you're.
You have to be really, really careful. You know, like you have to be cognizant every time.
Yeah.
It becomes a habit eventually.
Yeah,
like
eventually
the one on my face,
kinda...
I got it caught a few times on a towel.
Yeah, those are.
That's called a surface anchor, and it's a white gold 14-karat dollar sign. I just thought it was
yeah,
kind of cool.
Yeah, but how do you put it on?
Well, it's a surface anchor, so the jewelry itself is called a surface anchor, and basically it's a, you know, we're talking millimeters in size, but it's a small little foot with a post, and the post has internal threading in it. So basically what happens is, without getting graphic, the piercer uses a small biopsy punch. It just takes a tiny little hole out of your skin,
dude.
And then then they just slide the foot under, and so your skin goes whoosh, right around it, and you just got a little post, and then you can thread a gem in it, or a bead in it, or a flat, whatever you want. There's a lot of different tops, and
taking a tooth implant and put it on your face, man.
Maybe.
Yeah, but, yeah, yes.
You can like, put them anywhere. They're hugely popular. Ladies put them on their chests, arms,
no,
lower
yeah.
backs. It's super versatile. It's a single point of entry, so it's actually, like, compared to some of the alternatives for different piercings, it's actually a better option. And, you know, if it's done well and with good jewelry, you can take it out if you ever wanted to, and it's no more invasive than a regular piercing.
No kidding.
Yep.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, and all different types of people get them. A lot of women really like to have it here because it kind of looks like a floating diamond on your neck. And yep, it's cool.
Do they ever come out?
They can. I mean, if it's put in well with good jewelry and you're a little careful with it, you should be fine. But, you know, like I was saying, you want to watch out for towels and such.
So yeah.
They're the enemy.
Towels are the enemy.
What's the deal with the ear? I like that.
Which one? The earlobes?
Well, both. Yeah, the earlobes.
Well, those are just stretched ears, basically. They're, again, really popular. It's just you start from a regular piercing or you pierce to a large gauge, and then, you know, you gradually get bigger. I just always thought they looked cool, so years ago I got them because my wife was apprenticing to pierce and wanted to practice stretching, so I started maybe 8 years ago or 9 years ago.
Isn't that African based?
Again, they all have different origins, but it definitely comes more from that kind of tribal background, I would say. One of the things that I find really cool about it is, I mean, I'm not going to claim to know a lot about different gemstones and such, but we've got some really nice premium stones. So like these ones, for instance, are genuine amethyst. And I never even thought about it, honestly, when I put them in. I put them in because they matched my tide for my friend's wedding. Mm-hmm. And there was a lady that was big into stones that noticed them, and she said that amethysts bring you really good luck. So to have them close to your body was important, and she actually had a pendant on her keychain. And I thought, what could be better than having them in my earlobes, and so I've left them in ever since, and hopefully the luck keeps flowing.
Really?
Yep.
Yeah.
I can see people coming out with USB-based earlobe things like that.
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm. Here, yeah. I've got my business card right here.
Near field communication, NFC, you heard of that? All you have to do is get close to something. You don't need to USB, but near
yeah.
field communication in there, you just put your ear on your CD player and it starts playing.
Oh my God, that's so funny.
So what's your favorite aspect, Miranda, of your business? You're a tattoo artist?